subscribe to our channel now and press the bell icon to never miss an update from KIMS Global.
Hello, I'm Dr. Renu Thomas, Senior Consultant and Coordinator, Department of Urology, KIMS Hospital, Trivandrum. A wide range of treatment modalities is available for management of kidney stones. Most of the small stones can be treated with medicines. A stone inside the kidney as well as stones inside the ureter or even inside the bladder can be treated with medicines when the size of stone is small. But bigger stones or stones which cause obstruction or other complications will require other modalities of treatment. Stones which are not amenable for treatment with medicines will require some kind of intervention for the clearance. The treatment of kidney stones has evolved over time. In the early days of medicine, one had to adopt to open surgery to clear stones inside the kidneys or in the or in other parts of the urinary tract. But later, as technology advanced, more and more minimally invasive techniques were applied to the treatment of kidney stones as well as other urinary stones. And later on, non-invasive management of stones also came into vogue. One of the most important and popular non-invasive management of stone is ESWL. ESWL stands for extracorporeal shockwave lithotripsy. ESWL involves breaking of stones in a non-invasive manner. That means a cut is not made into the body of the patient and no instrument is introduced into the body of the patient. A machine which is applied to the skin surface is used to deliver shock waves which are focused onto the stones, and these shock waves fragment stones into small pieces. These small pieces are passed in the urine. Other surgical procedures used to treat stones are, most of these are minimally invasive procedures. One of the most popular minimally invasive procedure to treat stones which are lodged in the ureter, it is called as ureteroscopy and lithotripsy. Now, lithotripsy is a common term used in connection with management of stones. The literal meaning of lithotripsy is breaking of stones. Litho means stones and tripsy means breaking. Breaking of stones can be extracorporeal, as mentioned before, as ESWL. Or it can be intracorporeal. Intracorporeal means inside the body. This means that an instrument is introduced inside the body, the stone is visualized, and there are several modalities to break the stone. This is called intracorporeal lithotripsy. So one of the most popular method of breaking uretic stones is ureteroscopy and lithotripsy. The most common method used to break uretic stone is pneumatic lithotripsy. An instrument called as a pneumatic lithotripter is introduced through the ureteroscope. The stone is visualized and the stone is fragmented with the pneumatic lithotripter. Another very common and popular method to break stone is using laser. Again, the method to access stone is the same. The ureteroscope is introduced to see and visualize the stone, and a laser fiber is introduced and the stone is fragmented with laser energy. Another common surgical method adopted to clear large kidney stones is PCNL or percutaneous nephrolithotripsy. With PCNL, large stones and even stones filling the entire kidney, which are called as Tagon stones, can be cleared effectively. In this method, the instrument is passed directly into the kidney through the skin. The stone is visualized and again the stone is fragmented. The method of fragmentation of stone is again pneumatic lithotripsy, which is commonly applied. Another alternate option for clearing stone is ultrasonic lithotripsy. Advances in PCNL has also occurred with time, and these came in the form of miniaturization. Initially, PCNL used 1.5 to 2 cm wound to clear the stones, but with advancement of technology, the size of the instruments used to clear stones have come down, and we need progressively smaller and smaller incisions to introduce instruments into the kidney, and the energy sources which are used to clear stones have also improvised with technology. So the advancement in PCNL has come in the form of mini perk or mini PCNL, in which the size of the wound incision has lessened to a great extent, and now even there is something called as a micro perk. So with a 2 to 3 millimeter sized incision, one can introduce micro perk instrument into the kidney and fragment the stones with laser energy. Stones inside the urinary bladder have a different kind of instrument to break the stones, in which the instrument can be introduced through the urine passage. The stone can be visualized, and with the instrument called as the lithotrite, the stone can be fragmented.